I don't know if this is going to work or not, because I'm definitely not over technical with this self-tape business and speaking to a camera, which is a bit ridiculous really, because obviously I'm an actor, so yeah, but I normally run to Rick Carr to do my self-tapes because I'm really shit at them. Anyway, hi, good evening. It's just basically a little bit of an update, obviously, on my book, and to maybe explain the journey of the book, the reason for the book, and where I'm at with it, and I think the difficult thing with this book for me personally, to have to have written this book, is the book's been a bit of a journal. Each time I've gone to the book, I'm reflecting back at it and I've got different feelings towards things. And it's constantly changing. Do you know what I mean? So this book isn't one of those books where pick this book up and I've got all the answers of how to deal with bipolar disorder. And if you do Kundalini yoga and you do meditation and you go to the gym and you eat, you know, 6 meals a day, you will master your mind. If you stay away from men that like to cheat and fucking have narcissistic tendencies and like to be in jail and blah de blah de blah, you'll be fine, because that isn't what the book's about. The book is probably the biggest fuck up type of book you will ever pick up and read. That brings me on to the next thing, is I'm genuinely not bothered if anybody reads it or they don't. Will I publish it? Yeah, I'm going to have to, because that's kind of facing a fear to release it out there, I think, for me personally, into the universe, into the new decade, and to be able to go, right, okay, that's done. I've had to face some real hard facts with this book. The interviews was very difficult. The interviews was really difficult because you're having to hear people speak of you in a way that they've probably... certain things they've wanted to say to you for 10 years. There's been moments where I've had to close the mic and not been able to write anything at all because I'm so confused as to what I feel regarding certain situations. With the type of book it is, you know, and the type of person I am, you know, things change daily. And I think that's resembled in the book. And I've worked very hard, and so has the girl who's done the proofreading for me, Jo Swaby, which is a fucking legend, because she's literally carried me through with this whole process, to be honest with you, Jo, and thank you so much. And you know, I've got to a stage now. There was two stages with it, because you're still going through shit as you're writing the book. I'm not 40 years old looking back on the past 10 years. I'm 30 looking back on stuff that I'm still dealing with. But that was the whole aim for me with this book, is to write it as I'm still going through stuff, as I'm still trying to figure out stuff. I didn't want a polished little clean self-help book, because it's not a self-help book. It's a journey. I don't really like that word, really. It's real. And, you know, I've had to read certain things and go, no, I don't feel bad for that, because he's a cunt and I don't like him. And then I've had to read back and go, I shouldn't have behaved in that way, and that hurt somebody else. And then I've also gone through stages now where I've had moments where I've really accepted the fact that I have a chemical imbalance, and that I have this condition with my brain that makes me get fixated, that makes me get angry, and makes me, my moods change rapidly. I've had the acceptance of it, and then I've then also had the oh my God, this illness does this to me. And then I've also had that moment of gone, actually, no, sometimes you're just not a good person. You're not morally right. So, I mean, it's been it's been a hard thing to face, and I think regardless of the fact if you've got mental health issues or you don't, everybody has mental health that needs taking care of. And I think regardless of whether you're titled with something or you're not, things in life can affect you and make you act in different ways, and we all react and feel things very differently. That's something I've learnt from it. I've learnt that sometimes you will accept yourself and sometimes you won't. And I've learnt that I struggle to let things go massively, and that you repeat the same patterns. But I don't necessarily think that is just the bipolar. I think if we all really have to sit and write and look back at all the moments in our lives, what we've gone through, and then reflect back on them, I think everybody would probably find it quite difficult. Top and bottom of it is, if you read it, you read it. If you don't, you don't. The people that probably don't like me will probably be the first people that will pick it up, because they're nosy bastards. Some people will read it and be like, she's a dick, she's this, she's that. But I've already thought about myself, so. I'll finish this. Because I feel it's part of my healing. It's probably quite selfish. But if one person picks it up, laughs at it, finds it funny, or thinks, actually, I do that. I'm like that. I'm still dealing with that. Like, she's still dealing with that. Then it served its purpose. So that's where I'm up to. It will shortly be going through to its edit, which is quite scary. And for all the people that have believed in me with this, you all know who you are. And you have got a page dedicated to yourselves in the book, which is a gratitude page with every single person's name in there. But yeah, it's been very difficult. I'm coming to the last hurdle now. Joe Swaber, you've been an amazing, absolute fucking human being that I could not thank anymore if I tried. And Wednesday is going to be very difficult because I've got to put the final chapter in of the last 12 months, which has probably been the most difficult year for me, mentally and emotionally. And I've got to admit certain things that I don't particularly want to admit. But there's no point being truthful, because if I'm not, I'm not going to learn from it. So that's where I'm up to. And yeah, if you are planning on facing yourselves anytime soon, it's not easy. But hopefully we will come out the other side. Thank you.